students, parents, families, staff, and the entire Putnam County community. Welcome to the 54th annual commencement ceremony at Putnam County High School, and the first ever virtual ceremony at our school. My name is Clayton Teisinger, and I have the wonderful honor of serving as principal of our school. And as such, I have the even greater honor of presenting to you today the graduating class of 2020. The past 4 years have been nothing short of a journey for each of you graduates. The closure of this journey has not been what you wanted, and it's not been what any of us here at PC wanted for you. However, we have a choice in how and what we focus on during this time. And today, I implore you to focus on this amazing journey of 4 high school years and all the years of learning prior to that. Focus on the growth you've made from the day in August in 2016 when you first entered our auditorium as a freshman until the day you are watching this video. Because graduation is not one day, it is not one video, it is the collective memories and moments of all the individuals in your class. It's these hallowed memories you've created for yourself and for others that made you laugh, cry, grow, and reflect. It's the moments that are going to be forever etched in your minds and hearts, as well as ours here at PC. Beyond the learning, beyond the hours in class, it's the moments that defines you. It's the exams you pass, the nights of studying, it's the regional and conference championships, and the Pantera State Championship. It's the girls of the senior class who through all 4 years never lost a tug-of-war match during Spirit Week. It's Luis Gonzalez, forever holding the library door open every day and every passing period, it seems. And yes, it's the prank or joke that does not need to be repeated during this video. But above all, it's the relationships you built with each other, with staff here at PC, and with your families, as you continue to become the wonderful individuals you are today. Class of 2020, I ask you to reflect on this journey, to remember it for all that it has brought you and will continue to bring you in the many years to come. The closure of your high school career is officially here, but your journey can and will continue. So on behalf of all of us here at Putnam County High School and its district schools, congratulations on who you've become and on your graduation today. We're excited to see what great things you're going to continue to do.
Latin Honors was established at PCHS to provide merit to students for their individual academic growth and accomplishments throughout their years at PC. This year is the first class to receive these honors and be recognized for their progress and accomplishments in learning. There are 3 designations of honors. The first is cum laude, which is given to students earning a cumulative GPA of 3.33 to 3.79 on a 4.0 scale. We're proud and congratulate the following students on this achievement: Jennifer Alvarado, Shayla Arroyo, Kennedy Bezidlo, Madison Brannon, Emily Brook, Lily Carper, Braden Holmes, Avery Lamas, Jacob Pishka, Livia Sanchez, and Kelly Todd. Congratulations to our cum laude recipients. The next honor is magna cum laude, which is given to students with a cumulative GPA of 3.8 to 4.19. Congratulations to the following students on earning this merit: Luis Gonzalez, Tiana Green, Katrian Holacker, Cassandra Jansen, Jerry Lester, Lucas Olson, and Carter Trone. Congratulations to our magna cum laude recipients. Finally, the most distinguished honor is summa cum laude, which is provided to students with GPAs at and above a 4.2. Congratulations to our summa cum laude recipients, Molly Boyd, Megan Brooker, Morgan Hunley, Allie Chuchi, Savannah Tucker, Jacob Wiesbrock, and Dylan Zupek. Our purpose at Putnam County High School is learning, both the achievement of students as well as their individual growth throughout the years. As such, we'd like to recognize our top 10 students of the class of 2020 based on cumulative GPA in alphabetical order. Molly Boyd, Megan Brooker, Allie Chuchi, Katrian Holacker, Morgan Hunley. Cassandra Johnson. Lucas Olson. Savannah Tucker. Jacob Wiesbrock. And Dylan Zupek. Congratulations to our top 10 of the class of 2020. This year's salutatorian is Mr. Jacob Wiesbrock, son of Jason and Kelly Wiesbrock. While at Putnam County High School, Mr. Wiesbrock has been an active member in FFA, basketball, baseball, and National Honor Society. Please join me in congratulating and welcoming Mr. Jacob Wiesbrock as he gives the salutatory address.
Thank you, Mr. T. I would like to start by defining our class with one word, endure. We have had to endure just as much as other classes in the past 3.5 years, but over these 3 months, we've had to go through so much more. I will never forget never being able to play baseball ever again, turning in my uniform without ever having a senior season. Prom, graduation, all canceled. It's not quite how we imagined it, but we need to look on the bright side. There's more to come in the future, and more memories that we need to remember. With that being said, I'd like to share some of my memories. They will stick with me forever. I wouldn't trade any of them for the world. From jokes with Mr. Sale and PE to regular classroom time, they were all worth it. We have our normal memories, like every other class. First dances, first games, senior night, and just regular class time. But there's unique ones that will always stick with me. Some of my favorites include Ben on roller skates in a gorilla suit our freshman year during Spirit Week, and Mrs. Stewart dancing during our freshman Spirit Week. Not to mention breaking a clock. Mr. Sale, I'm sorry, that was not on accident. Happy camp, my freshman year as well, will always stick with me. These got us here today, and they will always bring us back. As for the future, we all plan to go different ways, from work, to trade school, to college. All of these are great options for us. But remember that they all lead back to this. Remember the good times, but recognize the good ones that are to be had. We need to stay together and remember each other as a class. The countless work that has gone in to this diploma is irrelevant compared to the stories, the character, and the memories that we have built. Those will forever be with us. I would like to thank the family, teachers, and faculty that have helped prepare us for our future and get us ready for what's ahead. For me especially, I would like to thank all my classmates. They invited me in like I was one of their own about 3.5 years ago. If you were to take anything away from this short little speech, I would like you to remember the life lessons, the memories, and the character building that we all went through these past 4 years. I wouldn't trade any of them for the world. I'd like to finish with a quote from country music singer Tim McGraw. When you get where you're going, don't forget to turn back around.
This year's valedictorian is Miss Megan Brooker, daughter of Jim and Sue Brooker. While finishing her high school graduation requirements, Miss Brooker has also been enrolled as a student at IBCC. This spring, she will not only graduate with us at PCHS, but she will earn her associate's degree through IBCC. I'm proud to share with you today in giving the valedictory speech, Miss Megan Brooker.
Welcome everyone to the Class of 2020 Commencement Ceremony. Mr. Carlson, Dr. Teisinger, the PC School Board, PCHS faculty and staff, and the parents and families of the graduates, thank you all for being here today to watch the final page of the first chapter of our lives come to its conclusion. While today will certainly be a ceremony no one will ever forget, it also ended in a way that many of us may not have imagined or hoped for. With this in mind, I think it is important to commend the graduates of this year for their creativity and resilience in the face of a tremendously difficult circumstance. These attributes will serve us all well as we begin the next step in the journey of the rest of our lives. Whether this next step includes higher education, the trades, military, or the workforce, it is undeniable that the last 12 years have been invaluable in preparing us for the amazing journey that lies ahead. The class of 2020 undoubtedly learned so much from each other and took away many experiences, all of which have shaped the unique people we have come to be. I think it is also important to remember that experiences become memories, which can never be taken away from us. Today is a day about not only recognizing how far we all have come, but also how far we all will go. If one thinks of all the things we have learned, people we have met, and all we have done in just 18 years, who can imagine what the next 18 will have in store? While the world changes by the week, the sentiments that make graduation such a special time remain unchanged. This speaks to the longevity of such bonds, that even in the face of crisis, we all remain stronger than ever. Inspired by all the amazing, long-lasting connections we have made, following this ceremony, we should be excited to go forward creating new relationships academically, professionally, and socially. Finally, I'd like to congratulate the Class of 2020 a final time. We truly were, virtually, the greatest class ever. Thank you.
On behalf of Mr. Steve Malavolti and Post 1044 of Hennepin, I have the honor of presenting this year's American Legion Awards. This year is the 94th year for the American Legion School Award Program. Since 1927, the program has recognized students who exemplify six qualities that define character. Qualities include courage, honor, leadership, patriotism, scholarship, and service. Each awardee receives a certificate and a medal with the six qualities on the face, and on the back bears the Marine Corps motto, Semper Fidelis, or Always Faithful. Every year the bar is raised for this selection, for every year we're seeing more and more young adults making a difference in their school and their community. Our recipients of this award have not been notified of this yet, so this will come as a surprise to them. For the 2020 Legion Award, Putnam County Seat Post 1044 of Hennepin, Illinois, proudly recognizes the traits of courage, scholarship, service, honor, and leadership for Molly Boyd and Jacob Wiesbrock. Congratulations to the recipients of this award. The Service Learning Program at Putnam County High School was established to promote citizenship by preparing our students to become tomorrow's leaders through preservation and conservation in our community. All students completed at least 24 hours in their 4 years at PCHS to meet this graduation requirement. The class of 2020 recorded 2,269 hours of service to Putnam County. Within this class, we'd like to recognize those students who individually recorded at least 100. We had three of these members serve at least 100 hours. We celebrate and thank the following individuals for their service to our community: Hannah Henderson, Jacob Wiesbrock, and Savannah Tucker. Thank you and congratulations on this honor.
Hello to each graduating senior of the class of 2020. As superintendent of our Putnam County Schools, I would much rather be presenting and confirming our graduates in person, surrounded by family and friends. Unfortunately, at this time, that is not possible. It has been a joy and honor to watch each of you grow and mature into terrific young individuals. We wish you all the best of luck in your future plans. And as superintendent of schools, and on behalf of the Putnam County School Board of Education, I confirm that each senior has met the state requirements to graduate high school. So congratulations to each graduating senior of the class of 2020. We wish you all the best of luck, and take care, everyone.